Hey guys, in this tutorial we're going to learn how to create a custom email address that matches your custom domain name so that people can email you at your website or your blog and you have a nice pretty email that's like your name or hello or admin or support at your domain name.com.org.net, what have you. And that way it looks a lot more professional than just a Gmail address. As a bonus at the end though, we will sync this with Gmail. It is free to do as long as you have a domain name and a self-hosted WordPress blog set up. If you've done those two things, then we're going to use the free services that come with our hosting software. And if you're trying to set up a custom email address without setting up a domain name or hosting, then you're sadly just shooting yourself in the foot, because these two things, a domain name and a self-hosted blog, are the bare minimum you need to be successful online. So you should get that set up. I'll leave you links in the comments on how to do that. And then we can create our custom email address like this one, greg@dearblogger.org, for free. All right, so let's do it. So the first step is to log into our hosting control panel. We use HostGator to host all of our websites. So that's also where the email files will be hosted. And to log in, you can just go to portal.hostgator.com. All right, now we're gonna click on the hosting tab. And we want to get to our control panel area. All right, so we're in our billing dashboard here with plenty of tools, but we want to get to our control panel. And I like doing that by clicking Launch Quick Install. All right, there are obviously other ways to get to your control panel, but from this window, we can just click on HostGator Control Panel in the upper left. And it's just how we like to do it. And that'll take us to our main menu here. And now in popular links, you can just click on email accounts. Now we're just going to enter in the new email that we want to create. I create new email addresses all the time for different blogs, forums, websites, client emails, so it's tough to think of a new one. But I think hello is always a good one. All right, so hello is the what goes before the at sign. Cool. You can write whatever you want there. Like support or admin, it won't matter. And now just click on the domain box and choose the right domain name. I like using a demo domain name, so just a demo is perfect. That's used in other YouTube demos. Now we just need a password. Perfect. Does not matter how weak or strong it is. Choose the unlimited quota for your mailbox, because why not? And then just click create account. So it'll say you successfully created an email account, need help setting up an email application, and we don't, because I'm gonna do that for you right here. Just doing that much will give you a new email inbox where you can actually receive new emails at. So how would you check those emails? Well, you could go back to the HostGator control panel. And now on the left-hand column, just click on email. And in the email area, go ahead and click on webmail. And you'll get a list of all the email addresses you might have created. So you just want to find the right email address. For example, we could use hello@gregorynarayan.com, which I've used for my freelance developing. And you just click access webmail. This will take you to a email inbox that looks slightly less sketchy than Hotmail. We'll click got it. Then we need to choose a default web application, so I just choose the first one. Horde is fine. And from this window, you can send and receive email addresses in this window that looks a lot like Hotmail. All right, so these are real emails I need to respond to, and yeah, we'll hopefully get on that pretty soon. You can figure out how to use all these tools on your own though, so really pretty easy. All right, but what if you don't want to log into HostGator to send and receive emails? Good news is we just set up a new custom email address for your blog or your business. The final step is just to sync it with Gmail in case you don't want to log into HostGator to check your email. So what we want to do is just close HostGator, close these windows, and we're going to go to Gmail. Gmail is set up so that you can actually use any different email address you want. It just isn't quite as easy to understand how to do it. So we're gonna show you how to do it right now. Okay, now in Gmail, all important changes start with the gear icon. So let's click on the gear for settings, and then just bring your mouse down and click on settings. Now let's click on accounts and import. And now scroll down, and where it says check mail from other accounts, click add a mail account. We'll drag that yellow window in here. Now just enter in the new email address we just created. Perfect, and click next. Make sure this import emails option is selected and click next. Now it's time to get some settings entered in correctly here. And it's tough to know these settings, but I know the settings from HostGator and I want them to match Gmail perfectly. So that's what we're gonna do. Gmail doesn't know that we're using HostGator necessarily. So it's important to know a little bit of what you're doing here, and I'll fill you guys in on exactly what to write so that it syncs with HostGator perfectly. So for a username, make sure you write in the full email address, whatever email you created earlier on in the tutorial. Perfect. Then for password, just write in the password that we set up in cPanel at HostGator. We can leave the PLP server the same as it is now. Port 110 is good, and then just check leave a copy of retrieve message on the server. That way, in case we don't get it in Gmail, it will still, that email address rather, will still be on our HostGator cPanel if you really need an email and it didn't make it to Gmail for whatever reason. Now just click add account and check yes, I want to be able to send mail as this email address, and click next. Very good, and now click next step. Now in this window, it's important to change the SMTP server to mail.just-a-demo.com, which we might have seen on the previous window, although we might not have remembered it. I'm just gonna remind you to enter in that mail like this, followed by whatever your domain name is. For username, you wanna write in that full email address again, if I could type, and password, write in that full password that you created in cPanel. For port, choose 587, choose secured connection using TLS, the recommended one, and click add account. Perfect. Next, it's gonna send you a verification code to your inbox, so just click back to your inbox. Might take a minute. All right, so by the power of hitting refresh a million times, we got the Gmail team confirmation email. Open that up and just grab the confirmation code that they give you. We're just gonna double click there and then copy it. And now let's open up that confirmation window from the step we were just doing. Paste in that code and click verify. So this will tell Gmail that you own that email address and that you're able to send and receive emails to it and from it. To prove to you that that's working, we can go back to our inbox, which I'm sorry about, it's a little bit of a mess, and just click compose as you normally would. Now from the drop down in from, just choose the option for that new email address we just set up. Very good. And test out an email, say to one of my other custom email addresses. And click send. And we'll refresh and see that it's working to send email from our custom email address. That's pretty cool. It's Greg from Greg's different email address, so we can effectively send email to this hello at our domain name email address, or whatever email you created at whatever domain name you manage. And now we can try to reply to it to see if that email can receive. And click send. And now we go back to our inbox, we can see that that email can receive as well. So it's working perfectly. Great job. All right, now that you know how to create a custom email address that matches your custom domain name and how to sync that new custom email address with your Gmail account, the final step is just to insert that email address on your blog or website so people can use it. So head over to your WordPress blog, click on the page that you want to insert the email address on, and click edit page. Now all you need to do is just be in the, preferably the text tab where I like making most of my edits. Come down to the bottom and write out that new email address. Perfect. Now just write some catchy text that would make someone want to email you, or maybe you don't want to be emailed, so just keep it pretty vague. All right, and then to make sure people can click on your email address, just highlight it, click link. WordPress will understand that it's a mail to URL, so you just need to leave that mail to in there or write it in if it didn't get in there somehow, just as it is on my screen right now, and click add link. All right, and now when you update and view page and scroll down, someone can click on your new custom email address and it'll open up their default email client with a new email template, and they're all set to go ahead and contact you about working together or guest posting for your blog or about any sort of other cool business opportunity. And they're gonna love emailing you now on your new custom professional email address that matches your domain name. All right, guys and gals, thanks so much for watching, because I love making these tutorials for you guys. If you have any questions about how to create your own custom email address that matches your domain name, let me know in the comments, and I'll talk to you soon. All right, guys, talk to you later.